Okay, I'm going to take a minute and show how to make a simple countdown timer in Excel. And so the first thing I'm going to do is just kind of create the form of it, and then I'll do the function of it. So I'm going to say, so I'm going to set a timer for, let's say, 5 minutes in Excel. It always goes hours, minutes, seconds, and I want to change the way this looks. Instead of doing hours, minutes, seconds, I just want to do minutes and seconds, because I'm not going to have hours in my countdown. I'm also going to want a couple ActiveX buttons. I'm going to copy and paste. One to start my timer, one to stop my timer. So I'm going to change the properties of these, the caption to, and the other one to stop timer. Now, one thing I'm also going to do is I'm going to insert a text box and make this text box equal to my countdown value. This will allow me to easily change the text size, move it around, change the background color, just some simple things like that. That you can't do easily if you tie it to a cell. So now this is just my basic functionality. So, or I'm sorry, the basic form. So I'll now deal with the functionality. If I go into design mode, I'm going to just set these buttons to run different subroutines that I will define. So start timer and stop timer respectively. Now I'm going to insert a module, and I'm going to do a define my start timer subroutine. So when this, when I start my timer, I want to do do an application on time of whatever now is plus a time value of 1 second. So basically in 1 second from now, I want to run a another subroutine. I'm going to name it next tick. So when I press that button, it's when I press the start timer button, it's just going to run this next tick in 1 second from now. So basically every second I'm going to subtract 1 second from the timer. So I'm going to do then a next tick subroutine. This is where I need to define what I want to do. So my cell value, or I'm sorry, the cell where the value is B1. So I want to make sheet 1 range B1 that value equal to itself minus a time value of, oops, one second. Then, once that's done, I need to run the start timer subroutine again, so that way it will say in another second from now, I need to subtract another second. So it'll just sit there and work in a loop. So then I also need to basically do a stop timer that will allow me to end the loop. So I'm going to do an application on time, basically the same. In order to stop an on-time event loop, basically you just do the same values, but then change the schedule to false. So if I come back here now, I should be able to take out of design mode, and it's just going to start counting down. I can stop, start, stop. Now, a couple things that we'll run into problems if we don't add a couple more lines of code. I'll show you if we get to, when you get down to zero, it will give you an error as our code says right now. So we will need to, because it's trying to subtract 1 second from zero, which it cannot do. So what I'm going to do is add a if statement. So if sheet 1 range B1 is equal to 0, then I want to exit the sub, exit the subroutine, so it won't try and subtract a second, and it will go ahead and cancel that loop. So now I should be able to reset this to 5 seconds again. And there we go, no error. Now the other thing that will happen is if you don't have a timer running and you hit stop timer, you're going to get an error because it's trying to cancel something that's not running. So the way to handle that is you add a error handler. So basically if it comes up with an error in this subroutine, it will just basically resume to the next line, which really is to end the subroutine. So I'll go ahead and reset that now. So now if I hit stop timer, I don't get an error. So this is just a basic timer. So you can set for you should do hours, minutes, seconds. I can set it for 1 minute. This will stop it, resume, stop. And this kind of just is a framework, and you can kind of opens the door to do a number of different things. One other thing I'll show real quick is, let's say when I get to 10 seconds, I want to change the background of this text box to be red. Otherwise, I want it to be white. So during my next tick application, after I subtract the second, I could say if sheet1.range b1.value is less than or equal to, let's do a time value of 10 seconds, then I want my my shape name is text box 1. Oops. So here I can set an RGB value, and let's say I want it to turn red. So I want everything else like that. So that's if it's less than 10 seconds. Otherwise, I'm going to just copy this line. Oops. And otherwise, I want to turn it white, which is RGB value of all 255. And then I want to end if. So let's see if this works. So if I come back here, I start my timer. Actually, I'm going to stop it. I'm going to set this for 15 seconds. So this should turn red at 10. So as you can see, it opens just a wide range of different things you can do and different events you can trigger. But that is how you do some basic time countdown functionality in Excel and VBA.